Okay, it's September 21st, 2015, 9:50 a.m. And since we have Monsanto products around us all the time now, and he's about ready to spray some Roundup after I complained about it yesterday, and the reply was, everything gives you cancer. So that's the mentality. Anyway, I'm gonna try not to swear. Best I'm trying to do is I've got to roll a trench all the way around this garden, three-fourths of it. Now what I'm doing is pulling the grass, the dead grass and all that back on. And plus all the stuff I've knocked out of the garden. When I knocked down sunflowers, I threw most of them away and burned them. Now I'm putting the stalks and all that back down in the trench here to try to just to protect a little cover. Because, you know, that's about 25 feet. No, actually it's about 20 feet from this edge right here to that edge right there where their field starts, and they'll start spraying that Roundup. Glyphosate-filled Roundup, or Roundup filled with glyphosate. So what my attempt is right now, I'm trying hard to cover the trench. I tilled it up this morning, and I thought to myself, well, you know what? He said he was going to do it today. But see, now it's calm out here, too, right now. There's no wind, which would prevent drift and such. Joke. Need like a 10-foot privacy fence just to protect the garden 10%. But anyway, as it is right now, I got this trench on three sides of the garden. And I'm going to put, you know, like I said before in an earlier video, sunflowers, three different types of sunflowers around here. So it'll attract a lot of bees, a lot of butterflies, and our hummingbirds. But, I've been going back across this trench and pulling the grass after I tilled it like 2 weeks ago. And I didn't get out last week like I was going to. So I'm just kind of like pushing the grass, the dead grass on top. It ain't going to do a lot, but it'll do more than just letting it sit like this. And whenever he decides to start spraying the Monsanto Roundup, there's a tanker back here. See that tanker back there? Yeah, that's mixed, getting water from the well to fill that up. That's probably Monsanto's Roundup right there, those boxes. Yeah, but anyway, that's what he's going to be using to spray 300 acres around us. And until then, I figured, well, I might as well make like a little, like I've been doing, a little diary, journal, or whatever you want to call it, on Facebook and YouTube. I cuss a lot, maybe because I'm more human than a lot of people. I don't know if that's a human thing, but I'm not a botanist. I'm not a horticulturalist. I may not know. I'm more of a more average, I think, than most people would actually think sometimes. But I say what's on my mind, which makes me not average, I guess, because most people just want to go along to get along. Going along to get along is going to get you dead, too. But this part I just connected this morning. Not connected, but there was a piece here and a piece there, and I just made it one big. So it's about 4 feet from CJ's grave and about 5 feet on the other side of CJ's grave, who died of cancer, by the way, duh, after we moved here. So, having had four dogs, and they tore down our house across over there so they could connect their farms, and then the dog getting cancer. Yeah, but dogs get cancer all the time. Yeah, just don't add to it by being in an area where you're exposed to chemicals, especially glyphosate. But you can't get a place for one dog, let alone having four at the time. So we just, they said you could move over there now, we'll help you, which they did. And this is half the size of what we had over there. It was an old house over there, but it was more homey. This is the homestead, I guess you'd say. We said, well, you know, it's kind of like, we can give you help now or you can wait until winter. They were saying like January is when they would start cultivating all that, and then we'd have to look for a place. So, well, yeah, there's your offer. You know, so we just took this. And it's been okay, privacy-wise. That's about it. It's smaller, and it's quiet, except in certain parts of the time, in the summer, in spring and summer, when they start doing this. Now, I'm trying to grow heirloom vegetables out here. All that stuff right there from the sunflower. I'm gonna knock down half of that one that's hanging out there for seeds for the winter to be pulling them. The rest of this will be pulled down here probably in the next day or two. And after he sprays these fields all around us, I want to wait till a few days after he's sprayed to pull the plastic back halfway and mix in some of that stuff right there in the middle, which were leaves from the okra plants and whatnot. I got some of those in the back ditch back there too, by the way. I was going to use those just where the okra was at. The okra's going to go up here, though. I'll have three or four rows of okra up front here. Tomatoes will go back where the okra is at. Everything else is up in the air about where everything's going to be. Except beans, I know, will be in the back because they crawl so long. But anyway, after 3 or 4 days, I'm going to say a week, maybe a week after he sprays, we'll peel that plastic back. I have to cut those stalks, peel the plastic back, till this up, put the plastic down, go to the other end, fold it in half, till it up, fold it back down. Put some lime down too before I fold it back down. And that'll be it for the winter. Okay, it's like I said, September 21st, 2015. So about the first week of October is around when we'll start doing all this part. This stuff will come down in about another 3 days or so, 4 days. Today's Monday, so by Friday, these will be gone. I'm trying to keep those big head ones right there. Those are those mammoth ones. I can't focus on this right there. You know, there's one in the back corner where I got one hanging off of it too. But, you know, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to grow things for sustainability, not for money. As far as I'm concerned, the only thing Monsanto is about is death and money. That's how my personal opinion. And you can agree with that or not. I'm not going to swear, like I said. It'd be nice if people would share this thing and I get a couple thousand views on it, because, I mean, I'm just trying to state a fact here, folks. Unless we start doing more natural gardening, you know, when he sprays all them fields across there, on the side, here, and here, and here, you know, 300 acres of Monsanto Roundup. Think about that, and you're right in the middle of it. Well, anyway, I hope that you people tried to do some things like I asked, suggested when I swore before a lot about growing some vegetables. Well, we got some peppers over there by the house. And see, I got some stones. I was going to build that up, make a little raised garden about 6 inches above the ground, 7 inches above the ground. I can't see again with this cracked viewfinder, but you'll get the picture. Sustainable living means crops that'll keep growing, not buying it from Monsanto. And if you don't buy it or can't afford it from Monsanto, you don't grow anything and you don't eat, and then you die. So that's what I'm trying to do.